Hey there and welcome back to the channel. I'm Dave, the Notion Coach, and in this video, we're taking a first look at Notion Projects, a new template with a set of databases meant to streamline project management in Notion. We'll talk about how it works, who it's for, and whether or not you should consider migrating to the new Notion Projects if you already have task and project databases set up. If you're new to the channel, we cover Notion's updates, latest features, as well as deep dives on end-to-end workflows in Notion. So subscribe if you want to stay up to date on all that stuff. This update is actually in the form of a template which was created by the Notion team, incorporating projects, tasks, and sprint databases, and is really aimed at making project management easier, especially for teams that are new to Notion or new to project management. As you may know, creating and maintaining databases for things like projects and tasks and relating them together, deciding what to roll up or what formulas to bring in certain information, can be a pretty daunting process, especially for small teams or for teams that don't have an in-house Notion expert. So this template is really designed to be a plug-and-play solution for teams to get up and running with project management as quickly as possible. To get access to Notion Projects, we'll head to the template section at the bottom of our sidebar. And from here, we'll see that in the suggested section, which is at the top left, we'll see two options, projects and tasks and project task and sprint. We'll focus on the second one mainly because there's some added functionality regarding sprints. So once we click into the template, we'll head to get template. And from here, we're going to decide what team space we want this to be added to if you've got team spaces turned on in your workspace. So we'll set this to Notion Coach. And then you'll also notice here, once we get the template, we have four new pages in our sidebar. And three of these are actually databases. And the third one, which is a sprint board, is actually looking at a formatted view of our task database. So let's get into how each of these databases work and how we can leverage sprints to manage tasks. Right off the bat, when we look at the task database, we'll already see some of the benefits of relational databases. In this case, we have a task list in the form of a table. But you can see here that it's grouped by projects. So these are actually the names of projects within that project's database. Let's open up a task to see what properties are available within the task database. Some of these are pretty common for tasks, specifically assignee, status, due date, priority level, etc. But you also notice a few additional properties, specifically the summary, which is leveraging Notion AI. So based on the property information that's filled in and the body of the page, Notion is essentially summarizing what's happening with this task. We can imagine if we have a task database view set up that is showing this property in a preview mode, we could scan across multiple tasks to get a better sense of what the action items are within a particular project or sprint. You'll also notice that there's the task ID. This is also a relatively new property. What this does is automatically number entries within a database. So this could be really helpful for sorting entries, especially if we've got databases with a lot of content. The only real edits that we can make to the number property is adjusting the prefix, but that number is staying in place. If we get back into the task database, we'll also see that there's a section for all tasks. I definitely recommend for clients when we are working with databases, we always want to have at least one view that shows every property visible by default, almost in a kind of spreadsheet format, just to be able to see every property that's available to make sure that we're not duplicating properties or potentially deleting any that are pretty important. So in this case, we could see everything in terms of what projects they're connected with in addition to sprints. So let's jump into projects, because in this, we've got a couple key views, some of which you may already have in your Notion workspace if you're managing projects. But the default view in this case is identifying whether a project is in the planning stage or in progress. So here we could actually just hide this since we're already grouping. But if we open up a project page, we can see again some of the standard things that we would associate with project management, including start and end dates, if there are blockers. And you can see here that it's also creating an AI generated summary of the project. The AI summaries really worked best when we have as many properties filled in as possible and we have content in the page body, just to be able to parse out the key information. You'll also notice that there's a pretty useful rollup here called completion, and this is bringing in the number of tasks that have been completed. Again, one of the many benefits of relational databases is we could not only connect databases, but bring in information from other databases and present them in useful ways. The next area I want to get into is sprints. So if you're new to sprints in project management, these are most common within product or engineering teams, but are becoming more popular across teams and departments in general. But what they allow us to do is plan tasks over, say, a two-week period across multiple projects. So rather than have to jump to different projects constantly, this allows us to have one dashboard where we can see tasks that are highest priority for the current sprint, make progress on that sprint, and once that's done, quickly move to the next sprint. So the very first view here is looking at the task database grouped by project. So we could open up specific projects and see what tasks are on deck for the current sprint. And we can see that it's grouped by status, so the typical Kanban style board view. And then you'll also notice some additional functionality within the sprint board, specifically the complete sprint button. So this is tied to the number of tasks for the current sprint. Completing the sprint will automatically jump us to the next sprint and mark that one as active. Very excited to be able to apply this to various databases. Sprints is technically still in beta, so it's really only available in this particular template. But we could imagine a lot of different use cases for setting up buttons tied to databases. If we jump into sprint planning, we could see here tasks grouped by sprint. This will allow us to plan ahead a little bit in terms of what tasks across all projects we'll be able to focus on for the current sprint and for future sprints. And then the backlog, if there are tasks that are not tied to a sprint, they'll show up in the backlog. So this will allow us to drag tasks into a particular sprint. And that way, when we're in a different view, that task will be visible for that sprint. If we jump into that third view called backlog, this will essentially filter tasks to only show those that are not part of a sprint. Again, if we use this for planning, we could click on the sprint property and then assign this to a particular sprint. And really just a quick and easy way to plan sprints with the right tasks and just leverage the sprint board for the day-to-day action. And just a quick note on the sprint database. If we open up a sprint to see the properties that are visible for that sprint, we could see here what the status of the sprint is, start and end date. We could also see the completed tasks. So similar to that projects property, this is automatically tied to tasks that are associated to this sprint. And we could also see the total number of tasks generated via a rollup from just counting the number of tasks that are tied to this sprint. So pretty minimal functionality when it comes to sprints, but I think the part that's probably the most exciting for teams will be this functionality where we've got the sprint board, we could tie a button to this board and automatically assign something as done. So when we complete this, we can move straight into the next sprint. And now we're looking at a different set of tasks. So I think for teams that have a lot of projects that are ongoing simultaneously, this could be a really useful way to make progress across multiple projects at the same time and really focus on the highest priority tasks over, say, a two-week period. So the big question is whether your team should migrate to the new Notion projects template. This is definitely a great option for teams that are either new to Notion or already using Notion for knowledge management but are thinking of also using it for project management as well. This offers a quick and easy plug and play option for jumping in, adding tasks, assigning them to projects, and you always have the option to use a sprint function or just use the projects and tasks version of the template. If your team is already managing projects in Notion and you've got your databases set up and your properties are customized to fit your team's needs, I would definitely not migrate to this new template and these new databases. Sprints is technically still in beta. That means that this functionality will likely be available for existing databases, in which case, if you wanted to set up a Sprints database similar to the template, you can do that while connecting to existing databases without losing all of those customizations and all of those custom views that you probably have set up. Definitely holding off if you're already managing projects in Notion, but great resource for teams that are jumping into project management in Notion. We'll definitely do a deep dive on Notion projects and getting this up and running for teams. If you've got any questions, ideas, or curiosities, definitely let me know in the comments. And let me know if there's other features or functionalities that you would like to see in Notion projects or would have expected to see in this release. And subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so to keep up to date with Notion's latest features. See you in the next video.